What's up, Jew? How you doing? Just washing out some screens. What's up, Jocelyn? Let me put my glasses on. Y'all know I struggle. What's up, Brad? How y'all doing? I'm washing out some screens today. Let me just get some new gloves because I took these off and put them back on. I'm good. I was gone. Yeah, today. I was gonna go live screen print earlier, but I'm probably gonna be back here tonight screen printing. The way things looking right now, I'm gonna go grab some gloves because I'm out of gloves back here. I'll be right back. I just went ahead and grabbed the whole box. That way I won't have to be coming back. Look, I got y'all sitting on top of my stove. Actually, I got two gloves, so I don't know what to do. What y'all working on today? I am washing some screens. I just got everything like hooked up the right way. Earlier in the week, last week or whatever. Let me see where I can put y'all at. I think if I put y'all right here, that's a better spot. Yeah, I think that's a better spot. But just got everything hooked up, so I'm not having to use my portable pressure washer right now. I'm probably not gonna be talking that much. I'm mostly just gonna be working. But since I ain't do much on video, I'm gonna have to take these glasses off. this other pressure washer, the portable one. I'm gonna wash the next screen out with that one. So I just wash the screens and then I put them in this little thing right here to catch the water. I'll show it to y'all. Right here, and I got like some butcher paper in it, and then when I put all of them in there, then I go back and I degrease them. That's the way I do it now, since I actually have room. But y'all know how I used to do it in the bathroom at the other place, like in the shower. All right, let me see. Find one that don't got too much ink on it, because I didn't really clean ink on these screens that much. We're gonna go with this one right here. We're gonna go with this one. I'm gonna get this portable pressure washer. Hopefully the battery is charged up enough for it. And I can let y'all see how that one works. Hopefully it's charged up enough. Since I need to empty the water out of it anyway. So this is the, let me put it on over here. So this is this black one right here, the one that's like kind of scrunched up. The one I did a video on a while back. So you gotta first wet the screen up. And this screen is tore right here, but I'm gonna use it anyway. I need to order some more screens. I'm gonna do that today. So you just spray that on there. Then that's the emulsion remover. But y'all can see it's ink up at the top part. Let me put some more. The electric pressure washer is better. But you can reclaim it. Thank you. brought some screens to dry, and I'm gonna wash these screens while I'm waiting for them, and then I'm gonna, I'll probably print something, at least one of these orders. What's left in here, pretty much. It's a little bit of stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and use this power washer to go ahead and knock that out. Like, really, you're supposed to get all this ink out of here, but some of this stuff, I was lazy and didn't get it out. Let's see, go ahead and do this one. Move this other one out the way. Talking about over here. What's wrong with me? You said, what's wrong with you? What's up? I don't know. I tried to wash screens this weekend, but the granddaughter would. Hey, yeah, you should put the granddaughter to washing some screens. Even if she's 2 or 3 years old, she know how to, she can learn how to wash some screens. Ah. Let me go ahead and try to get some of this out. right here, they've been like this for a minute. Y'all see they're blue? I don't really even use the blue emulsion no more. I guess after I wash these out, I don't have that many. I'm probably about to coat screens in a minute. I'm gonna wash this one and then I'm gonna coat these screens because the other screens should be dry. And then I'm gonna come back to washing out screens, and by the time I finish, the other screens should be dry so I can burn the screens. I be having, like, it really wouldn't take so long to get ready to screen print, but I be having some screens done, but I need to order some emulsion. I was trying to order because MacB Supply, the place that I usually order from, they have turned into GSG. So I was trying to order from GSG. I called them last week and they have not returned my call because I was at the other building and I have to change my address, but you have to call them in order to change your address so that I make sure that I get my stuff that I order, and they haven't called me back. So I guess I'm gonna have to find another place to order from. And I was actually getting ready to order some more thread. I have like over $100 worth of stuff in my shopping cart and I can't go ahead and check out, or I may not get my stuff. We just get a new one because it's the old address and we got a new UPS driver. The old guy, he probably would bring it here eventually, but the new guy don't know. So I don't want to order that much stuff and then it never get here when it should be here like next day. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and go coat these screens. I think these other screens should be dry. The ones that I had washed earlier, and I was like, let me just go in and wash some screens. Sweat. So I was like, let me just go on and wash some screens because screen all wet. My dip tank is right there. I don't want to use it anymore. Actually, I want to get another smaller dip tank so that I can just like put my screens in there. I don't think I'm gonna use the dip tank anymore. I mean, I could use it, but when I did the classes in New Orleans and I went to United Ink, he gave me an awesome idea. So I want to do like he doing, cause it works out pretty good. I had been trying to buy a smaller dip tank to do what I'm trying to do, but they were sold out. Actually, I saw them on there and I should have went. It's like everybody must have had the same idea at the same time that I had it, because like I waited a couple days and I went back and they didn't have any more. So I'm gonna turn this light off, the main light, and well, it's gonna be those two lights, and I'm gonna turn on these other lights, and y'all will be able to see what I'm doing. Actually, let me go ahead and check these screens and make sure they're dry, because I didn't turn on the heater. I think they're dry, but I'm gonna turn this heater on and give them a little bit more time so that I can make sure they dry. I got like the dip tank lid up there. I think I found a trash can on Amazon for a dip tank. Hey, if it'll work, if it'll fit. I just bought a, you know what? Look, you just gave me another idea. Let me see. Let me bring this screen up in here. I just bought a, well, not just bought it, but a while back I bought a trash can for the room with the big screen in it. Like right here, this trash can, it's like a square trash can. Let me see. It won't fit in here though. Won't even fit if I do it sideways, because it's like a kind of like a squared. I thought I flipped the camera. It's like a square trash can or rectangle. I said square. Rectangle right there. So I was like, maybe that'll work. Hey, if that was the right size. If you're not using the 20 by 24 screens, it'll probably be the perfect size. But nope, it don't fit. All right, I'm gonna get those screens a few more minutes to dry because I forgot to turn the heater on. And I'm gonna wait over here and chat with y'all for a minute, because it shouldn't take too long, because they really dry. It's just like the ends of them is still wet, the metal part. So I want to just make sure they dry before I do them. Jewel, what you working on today? And where your grandbaby at? Your grandbaby Prince Church yet? Y'all, I was talking to my sister this weekend. So I'm probably gonna be doing something different pretty soon, y'all. It's like so much behind the scenes stuff, y'all. Like how I haven't been able to get the videos edited and stuff, and I've been tired. Like, I don't know, I feel like God don't want me editing the videos or something right now, because it's like every time I start editing, I get sleepy. I get too sleepy to edit. So I'm just like, you know what? I'ma just kind of take some time away from them, because I got like a whole bunch of videos like right back here. Look, I don't even want to show y'all yet. It's something right behind, right over here that I've been working on. That's another video. But like in this back area back here, like, let me see.
like in this back area back here, it's gonna be being worked on and stuff like that. You know, it need a little bit of work before I can do. And the pool table is gonna go up out of here too. But and then like, I don't know, it's just a lot of stuff, y'all. It's a lot of stuff that's being worked on kind of behind the scenes. And I did my first patches this weekend too, y'all. I had came over here on Saturday. I was gonna do it on live, but I did some patches this weekend. So I don't know. I'm gonna be working on some different things behind the scenes, and eventually I will get those videos edited, and y'all get to see them. And I'm just like wiping some of this ink off of these screens right now, like how you got ink on the screens, like on the sides right here. Just trying to wipe some of that off. Because if you don't, it'll get on your hands and stuff. Because it's not gonna go nowhere. Get that up off the floor. Yeah, just trying to get some of that ink off. Because these screens should be dry here shortly. Like when you don't clean it, the ink off kind of makes a mess like that. Maybe I should go back and clean some ink off of those screens. What's up, Four Corners? How you doing? Yeah, just here washing some screens. Let me see, I'm gonna just toss that towel over there. Just here washing some screens and getting ready to coat some screens so that I can work in a minute. I'm gonna go ahead and get some of this paper to put down on this table. I always put paper down on this table up in here so that I won't get emulsion on it. I don't know, this the Ryanette emulsion, I don't know if I messed it up. I don't know, I'm just having some issues with it. Like, when I use it the same day, I usually don't have issues with it, but if it's got to stay in there for a couple days, then I've been having some issues. I don't know. And then I don't know. It's like I might have put too much water in it or something. I don't know. But yeah, I was doing something back here with this plastic right here on the table. And I'll be right back. All right, thank you.
off this main light. And hopefully, yeah, y'all can still see. Y'all can still see. I always close this back up because one time I spilled almost a whole bottle of this stuff. I need to just sew this thing together, y'all, because it's not how it needs to be to cover my screens, but
What's up, Karen? What's up, Jesse? Y'all see my homemade washout booth with the backlight? The homemade backlight washout booth? Where they do that at? Where they do that at, y'all? If y'all haven't seen my backlight, my washout booth video, y'all can check that out and see how I got this backlight here. So I can check and make sure everything is clear, the screen is clear. Y'all hold up, this my mom. Give me a sec. Hello? Yes, ma'am. All right, well, I don't really talk to her no more. What? I got one, I'll send you the info. All right, bye. Sorry about that, y'all. Give me a second, y'all. I gotta do something right quick, and I'll be right back. Sorry about that. All right, y'all, I'm back.
I am back.
And I should have, it's 1:29 right now. It take like 15 minutes for that, those screens to dry. 20 minutes maybe. So.
screens are hard to wash because they got all this ink on them. Maybe I should get some ink remover, but we done made this for now. I forgot to wet it first. I don't take the tape or nothing off. I just put them up in here. You should remove the tape and you should remove all the ink. They wouldn't even be hard to wash out if I would have did that. But these are like old screens that was like, when I moved, I had them in a trash bag. Thank you. all I'm gonna do right now. These other two, they gonna have their day another day. Then I gotta come back and degrease them, dehaze them, degrease them. Just got ink on my screen. All right, I'm gonna let me check these screens right quick. See if they ready. Then I can burn this one screen. And then I'm gonna go print these other shirts. Dry. It don't take them long. My bad, y'all. Not even y'all can't even see. It don't take them long to dry. They are dry already. So I go ahead and turn this heater off. Turn the fan off. Did I turn the heater off? I got ink everywhere on me. What'd I just do with that paper towel? I look like a Dalmatian or something now. Let's see. Hopefully this will come out right the first time, because I had some issues. Y'all, I be having to burn that Ryanet emulsion for 45 seconds, because if I don't, it's going to be running on the screen. Usually it don't take that long to burn emulsion. Y'all can see the design in there. I don't know if y'all can. And I don't know. I be having issues with this emulsion for whatever reason, really. I don't even know. I'm going to use this other pressure washer because I feel like that's going to cause an issue. Y'all see right? Y'all might not can see. But it's, I don't even know. See how it's messed up. I don't know. The little one came out better than the big one. And I've been having just issues because I tried to burn these screens last week 3 times. That's why I'm having to wash more screens out. I believe it's that emulsion, because I don't usually use that emulsion. Ryan had sent it to me for free, and since I needed more emulsion, I was just using it. Because I've been trying to order some emulsion, and I can't get GSG to even call me back so I can change my address so I can order it. Guess I'm gonna call them again. Phone.
gotta plug this iPhone up, cause it just be dying for no reason. And I had it slightly over a year. And my other phone I had for multiple years. Got ink everywhere. It's almost 2 o'clock. Let me try calling them again. Let me get this charger just in case. It ain't no use in leaving a voicemail because I have left voicemails and they don't call you back. Even after a week. I got ink everywhere. A lot of the stuff that I need, they don't even have it in stock. Like the threads, different threads and stuff. So I had to go ahead and go to Madeira to order.
Thank you for continuing to hold.
I hate when they do that. When they could just let the music play until they get ready to answer. Leave a message and then I'm gonna call them back. I guess I don't have the option no more. Last time I did all this waiting, then the person who answered the phone was like, you have to change your address through accounting, so let me transfer you. So I call accounting and was forced to leave a message because that was all you could do. And they just never will call you back. Let's see if they got a chat on here.
Thank you for continuing to hold. Your business is important to us. We will be with you as soon as possible. To leave a message, please press 1 or remain on the line for the next available representative. PSG Sales, this is Rodney.
Yes, I had called last week trying to change my address because I got stuff in my shopping cart that I was trying to purchase since last week. And I left a message with, because they was like, let me transfer you because you have to do that with accounting. But nobody has called me back since last week.
Okay, have you logged in to see if your new address has been changed or no?
Nobody. I haven't even spoke to anybody to be able to change my address because they never called me back.
Okay. I can do that for you right now.
Okay.
Bye.
Alright, bye-bye.
Hey, you think they on live, Brad? They ought to do right. And they, like, that's what I try to teach my kids. If you don't want nobody to know what you did, don't do it. I don't, Brad says, I hate the way their shipping works. Yeah, this will be my first time. Last time I ordered, I picked up. But this will be my first time ordering because I used to always order from MacB Supply. But MacB Supply is now part of the, you know, they acquired it or whatever. I don't know exactly how that happened. But they took over MacB Supply. And I've been like just waiting on them to call me back. And like I had been busy, so I wasn't able to like just call them back all the time. But every time I have that problem and mess up screens, then I'll think about it and I'll call them back. But yeah, I guess I'm gonna go ahead. I got ink all on my face, y'all. I got ink everywhere. Let me go up in here and I'm gonna go ahead and screen print this one order, and then I gotta go get the screens from the back because it's the same order I just screen printed last week. But they order shirts so often. So I gotta print it again. I don't know what they be doing. Maybe they be throwing their shirts out into the crowd or something. I don't know. That's all I can see. For them to have to order shirts so often. But it's good for me. But it just made me wonder, what are y'all doing with y'all shirts? Do y'all throw y'all shirts into the crowd? I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get these screens, this screen. This same design right here, the flip mode design. It's a lot of movement in there, it seems like.
everything is good. Let me get my little chair thing so I can make sure there are no pinholes in it. And then I'm going to let me see, I'm gonna bring y'all over here while I put the ink on here. Like smaller things, but I need to order another one of these. This other screen. This is that's the spirit shirt design I was printing last week. Right quick. ahead and do a test print. Now I got spam risk calling me. Hello? Hello? Yeah, that's one of these fraud people.
We have your information, ma'am, but due to the safety protocol, we are not allowed to disclose any information.
Hey, y'all tell me a fancy car. Y'all tell me a fancy car so I can tell this to this lady.
Hello?
Yes, I'm here.
Yes.
Y'all call me.
Hello?
Y'all don't have my information? Because the thing said y'all have my information. That y'all got my file. You want me to just give you this phone number y'all just called so you can get my information?
I understand your caution, ma'am, but due to the safety protocol, to protect your information, we cannot disclose your information without your verification, ma'am.
Yeah.
So can you please verify the year? Yeah.
How y'all get my phone number?
Yes.
How did y'all get my phone number?
Okay, ma'am.
Huh?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you for taking this call. Have a great day.
All right, you too. Look, they act like they got my information. Y'all the ones call me. You said your muddy voice. Hey, a rose voice. That's what I should have said, fam. I didn't even see it until just... A Rolls Royce Platinum, that's what I should have said. That's funny. Hey, I'm gonna have to remember because they call me all the time and my phone says spam. My phone says spam. Karen was just trying to call me. Let me call her back.
I need to order some of those things for those other I didn't really mix this ink up good. So right now I'm just trying to get all the ink to go through the screen. Because the ink is not mixed so good. But I got a trick for it. Just taking a look at this stuff right here. I'm scared to touch it. It might not be dry. Okay, it's dry. Test print because the ink is coming through. This is cool, I think. Spatula so I can mix this ink up. Pencils I didn't design, I just stepped down to a little position where I don't have to bring away pen. Oh, that was what you was talking about. Let me see, I'm good. Enjoying my last week of freedom. I reassigned my, excuse me, to a less. Hey, but your t-shirt business finna take off, fam. Especially with that embroidery. You about to blow up. And after a while, you'll be able to go ahead and give them everything. getting dry. This should be last test for y'all, and I can go ahead and get to print. No, the screen is not blacked out, Karen. You can't see me? Can anybody else see me? So y'all can't see me, the screen blacked out. That's these iPads, I guess. That's just these iPads, y'all. And this is the iPad Pro that I'm using. Can y'all hear me? So y'all make sure y'all don't buy the iPad Pro, especially the 2020 iPad Pro, because issues. I guess it's tired of working today, but I'm going to go ahead and get off of here, y'all. Prince Squad out.